To estimate financial intermediation service indirectly measured, or FISIM, we need two main elements: pure rate of interest as the reference rate, and actual interest payable or receivable by the financial corporation. Let's look at an example of FISIM on loans. Bank A, resident of country A, has $5,000 outstanding in one-year loans to non-resident, non-financial corporations. The actual interest receivable on these loans is $500, implying an annual rate of interest of 10%. The interbank rate, or reference rate, between the resident and non-resident financial corporations is 6%. Under this scenario, FISIM on loans to non-residents earned by Bank A is calculated as actual interest receivable, $500, minus pure interest receivable, $300, which equals $200. Let's now look at an example of FISIM on deposits. Bank A also has deposits from non-resident households of $7,000. The actual interest payable on these deposits is $280, implying an annual rate of interest of 4%. The interbank rate between resident and non-resident financial corporations is 6%. Under this scenario, FISIM on deposits from non-residents earned by Bank A is calculated as pure interest payable, $420, minus actual interest payable, $280, which equals $140. The balance of payments entries for FISIM and interest on the loans and deposits are as follows. In the services account of country A, the entries for FISIM receivable would be 340 credit, 200 plus 140. In the primary income account, the entries would be interest receivable on loans to non-resident non-financial corporations, 300 credit, that is the pure interest. Interest payable on deposits to non-resident households equals 420 debit. That is the pure interest.